Hey everyone, I hope you're doing great. I know you guys have been waiting for the next video of the 777. I'm doing my best to release these videos as quickly as possible. So in this video, we're gonna cut all the contour surfaces and install the EDFs. Talking about the EDFs. These are the EDFs. Massive. I'll tell you more about this one later. And so before we get to the video, I wanna ask you guys again to subscribe. We are that close to hit a million subscribers. We have one more video which is going to be installing the electronics, and then it's going to be the main flight. That is hopefully going to be as well really soon. All right, thank you guys so much, and let's get to work. All right, in the previous video, we finished the wings, and now we are going to start cutting the flaps. The flaps, of course, are going to be massive. Therefore, we will have to use some heavy duty hinges. And these hinges are going to be made out of 6mm carbon fiber. Super lightweight and super strong. Now we will also make spoilers on this plane, which are the speed brakes. They will look, of course, super scale, and they will definitely help it to slow down after landing. We were planning to add slats on this plane, but unfortunately we had to cancel that because we could not find lightweight and strong actuators that have the required extension and have a good effect to actually operate correctly. Another obstacle was that these wings are foam core. We will have to make big cuts on the leading edge, which might risk the integrity of the wing. But in the future, when we build a plane that has molded wings, making the slats would be much, much easier. Alright, here are the spoilers, are glued back on the wings. Not actually glued, there is plastic in here, so I can break them off later. And now I have a fiberglass on both sides. This fiberglass is to reinforce this area, cover the foam, protect it, and also to make the spoilers more rigid. We are going to slice these afterwards, so now we will leave this to cure until tomorrow, break them off and then put them back on this, and then we're gonna put a Kevlar in, just like this thickness maybe, Kevlar on the skin. Easy, quick. And these are the flaps, they are also ready. This is just one thin layer of fiberglass. This here, by the way, this is just Dubron. Normal Dubron, it's an 8mm thickness Dubron, which is perfect for this. So hopefully we can cut the hinges and start gluing these on the wings. I'm so excited. This video is sponsored by BCBWay. BCBWay offers custom BCB prototyping service. You can get an instant quote with minimum quantity requirements and starting prices from only $5. They also offer 3D printing, CNC machining, sheet metal fabrication, and injection molding. Learn more at bcbway.com.
All right, so this is the wingtip hinge. I think this looks really scale. It took me some time to make this, hinge function just like the full scale. It's very close, very close. Now this is 3D printed, and this was the quickest way to actually make this hinge work. Of course, we thought about machining this out of wood or even aluminium, but it will take so much time, and it's gonna be maybe heavy. I mean, woods, I don't know how will this be machined. 3D printing was actually the best way, and it should be, this would be strong enough. I mean, the lock here is carbon, and the control horn is also carbon. The rest of the wingtip is going to be just foam. I'm gonna glue it on that and then wrap it with maybe just one layer of carbon and keep it light. And yeah, I like this. It works really good. So the test would be in flight. I mean, when it's locked, it's really locked, super strong. All right, it's looking good. Alright, we are finally done with all the contour surfaces. Everything is ready, everything is connected. Flaps on both wings are the exact same. They go down 37 degrees. For now, this is the max. If we feel we need more, we can add, we can change the servo arms. This is super scale, fantastic. I love this. The ailerons are done. They look so clean, so nice. The other wingtip is right there. I just glued it. And these are the horizontal stabilizers, also done. We did not film with that because Will did all these. I was not here even. So he did all this, they look amazing. So these are the molds for the nacelles. We have a lot of them. These are the intakes, cowlings, sides. This is the balun mold. So now we will start with these and also install the balun on the wings. And yeah, I can't wait to see those motors installed. These things are massive. Alright, success. This balun is super strong. This is 6 mil carbon, and this is just wood, but this one is actually connected to the aluminium bar and to the second carbon tube that's going here, so this is not going anywhere. There is a 30 millimeters carbon tube going through this, and this whole balun is actually enclosed top and bottom, so it's boxed, and that made it so rigid, super strong. This EDF, as you can see, is from Vasifan. Those EDFs, we've been using them for a while now. They are actually amazing. This EDF is the 390 millimeters in diameter. The best thing about this fan is the size of it. It's almost perfectly scale. So it's gonna look super scale, and we're gonna have tons of power. Thank you. Alright, look at this. This thing is a monster. I mean, the whole engine, the whole nacelle is massive. The diameter of it is just as big as the BC that we built a while ago. This thing is humongous. Anyways, this is now glued. This whole thing is glued. The ADF is of course bolted in. And if we want to access this for some reason, if we want to access the ADF, we can just cut a hatch in the bottom, take the ADF out. We are of course still missing the thrust tube. We're working on that. And these here are the bylon covers. One here, one the other side. These are just taped now. We still have to fish the wires to the ESC. Then we can close this for good. And this bulkhead will be also glued inside afterwards when the thrust tube is done. So this will be, you know, holding the thrust tube. I'm super happy with this. It is looking super scale, just like the GE9X. The fuselage is also almost finished. Mike and his guys spent, I think, 3-4 weeks on this. Primed it, sanded, they cut every single window. All the windows, this is just taped now. All the windows with 3D printed frames inside. They killed it, it's beautiful. Also the cockpit windows, they are great. And from the side here, you see how accurate they are. Fantastic. All right, that's it for this video. These things are, see the size of it. It's crazy. One more video to go. We will install the electronics, wire everything, finish whatever we have left in here. This means the next video, we will see the plane on, taxiing, running on its own power. Anyways, stay tuned for the next video, maybe in 1 week, and the week after that, hopefully, if we get the good weather, will be the main flight. All right, I'll see you guys very soon.